Hello, Philippines Mabuhay. So I'm back. So today we're going to discuss about obesity. What is obesity? What are the causes and the symptoms of obesity? What is the tool being used by the healthcare team or your family doctor or your medical doctors or specialist in order to determine or categorize your weight if it is indeed obese or in the category of obesity, be it low, mild, or high. So how do we interpret and measure your weight status using the BMI? So that would be our focus today. So obesity is a condition or a disorder in which there is an accumulation of excess fat in our body, which could lead to health issues in the long run if it is uncontrolled or prevented. What are the causes of obesity? There are various factors or combination of factors. It could be genetics or hereditary predisposition. It could be behavioral or lifestyle factors. It could be metabolic factors, or it could be hormonal factors. So those factors I mentioned are the influencers for being obese, or if you'll be suffering from obesity. What are the symptoms of obesity? Very good question. The symptoms of obesity are the following. These are just some of the symptoms. Number one, you could have joint problems. Like, for example, if you could have like a low back pain. Why? Because due to an excessive amount of weight in front of the body or in your abdomen, it's gonna pull your spine, or it's gonna put more pressure on the spine, leading you to have back problems, or that could lead you to have back dysfunction. It could either be a disc problem, a spinal vertebra problem. So that could be uncomfortable if you are very obese or obese. You could be, or you could have snoring issues or problems. You know, obese people are prone to snore. They're prone to develop sleep apnea or obstructive sleep apnea. Sleep apnea is defined as a cessation of breathing while you are asleep. So just like you're breathing and then it stops, breathing stops. It's a cycle. No wonder after a few hours upon waking up in the morning, you still feel tired or over fatigue despite you slept early the past night. So that is sleep apnea. And just to let you know that this sleep apnea, if it's left untreated, eventually could lead you to have other health issues. One of them is CVA, or cardiovascular accident, or your or namely as stroke. You could have like overweight. Physically, it is very obvious if a person would be obese. Visually, you can tell if a person is obese. So those are just the symptoms of obesity. Now, how could we interpret your weight status? Okay, this is through determination of your BMI or your body mass index, or through waistline measurement or waistline circumference measurement. Just to let you know, the research has proven that a man who has a 40-inch and above waistline or circumference, or waist circumference, that particular person would be suffering from detrimental health effects in the long run. He could be a very high risk to have detrimental health issues. And for women, if your waistline or circumferential measurement would be 35 inches and above, you are going to be signified as a high risk to have a detrimental health issues because of being so overweight. Now, what is BMI? So BMI is defined as the body mass index. This is not a diagnostic tool or diagnostic procedure. However, it is being used by the healthcare team or by the medical practitioners, your doctors, family physician, or your specialists, in order for you to be determined if your weight belongs to a certain category. Like, for example, I am 5'7", and that's my height, and my weight is 191 to 192. So if I'm going to divide my my weight and over divided by my height in inches, when I tried it using the BMI equation, it gave me a result of 30 pounds. So I belong to the low risk, or the class A or the class 1 obese category. So body mass index is like a weight and height ratio, and then using the BMI equation, the given result will be checked accordingly based on the BMI chart. So for the BMI or the body mass index chart, your weight can be determined if you are underweight, normal, overweight, or obese. And this obese category is being divided into three classes or grades. Class 1, 2, and 3, or grade 1, 2, and 3. Grade 1, which is the low-risk obesity. Grade 2 would be your moderate-risk obesity. Grade 3 would be your high-risk, meaning to say severe or morbid obesity. This sounds, you know, very detrimental to a person's health. So the BMI show ranges of your weight. Supposing obesity, so 30 pounds and above. And below 30, maybe 25 to 29 point something, could be overweight. And then 24 down to 19, that could be normal. And below 19 pounds, that weight ranges there could classify you as underweight. However, we're not talking the underweight here. We'll be focusing more on the opposite, which is the obesity. Because as we all know, that obesity is a major problem not only here in America, but also worldwide. So that ends the partial discussion of obesity. So we'll do the second part, which is the final, on my next blog. You all take care. And God bless everyone. Bye.